what did Sonny do now?
Well, he bought me this really beautiful, really expensive diamond bracelet.
So far, I don't see the problem.
Well, I tried to give it back to him.
You're allergic to diamonds?
I think I'm allergic to Sonny. Lo, he's so sexy and exciting, and he does all these outrageous things, and it's great. But he scares me.
Yeah, that's a man for you.
No, I mean, Sonny literally scares me. And I just feel like if I want to live to a good old age, that I should slow things down. So obviously I had to give him back the bracelet.
Did it work?
I called him. And then I hurt his feelings. So, you know, I thought I should take it back to him in person.
Uh-huh.
So we're at the grill. And in walks his dinner date.
No.
This blonde girl.
And I felt like I was intruding. Or worse, like I had offended him by being there. I don't know, Lo. I don't know if he's set up this whole thing to intrigue me or to make me jealous, or maybe playing the field is just the way he is.
Sonny is what he is, Bren. I wouldn't waste my time trying to reform him if that's what you mean.
I don't even know what I mean anymore. I mean, now maybe I want him because I can't have him. Or maybe it's the unpredictable part of him that is attracting me the most. And what does that say about me?
That you're feeling normal.
What's normal?
Well, a relationship with a little bit of predictability in it.
Do I need this? Do I need this?
Do we need men at all, huh?
Yeah. Of course we do. Well, I have no idea why men have to complicate things so much as it is.
I mean, Eddie's doing the same thing. Brent, talk about mixed signals.
Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, he's my rock and roll baby. Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays, he's this hard-driving, untouchable businessman. I mean, would the real Eddie Main please stand up?
How'd the gig at the resort go?
Yeah, well. Oh, that went great. It went so great until my pops decided to give Eddie the third degree.
Wait, you mean like in the fishing for the old prospective son-in-law?
Yeah. Oh, Bren, no. I almost died. I mean, hello? Welcome back to sophomore year.
The old will you take care of my little girl routine?
Yeah, no. But he put it in music terms. I'm telling you, he was about as subtle as a cement mixer falling on your head. I know he made Eddie feel so guilty.
Good. Maybe he should feel guilty.
Oh, hey. No, there he is right now. Okay, I gotta go.
If it's not him, will you call me back?
Yes, I'll call you later anyway, okay?
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Bren, Sonny is what he is. And I wouldn't waste my time trying to reform him if that's what you mean.
What's normal?
Well, maybe a relationship with just a tiny bit of predictability to it.
Is that what I really want? I guess it has its advantages. Still. Honey, how was work?
Work was good. Barnes has a real feel for the job. I think he's going to work out just fine. We're going to have to change all the fluorescents in the office with new halogen lights. But everything's fine. Grosses are up 4% over last quarter. The brass is pleased. So many details, but just like Mr. Downey says, where there's a plan, success follows.
That's great, honey.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you getting undressed? You're going to take me out, remember?
No, Brenda, no can do.
We haven't gone out in weeks.
Brenda, I have to get up early in the morning and to run my 3 miles. I have an early staff meeting, and I need my 20 minutes to organize my briefcase.
I'll organize your briefcase.
Brenda, I need my 10 hours of sleep. You know that, don't you, honey? You understand now.
Why can't some other salesman do it, darling?
Honey, Bunch, please. I have built a relationship with these people, and they trust me. What if I was to say to Mr. Jones, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to, like, have somebody else do your theft and fire policy. What would he think of me?
Did you have a life, maybe?
That I didn't care. And care is the pavement of the road to success. Besides, if I want a shot at that exclusive million-dollar sales club, I have to keep at it. Early bird makes the sales. Did you say something?
No.
Okay. Okay. A, B, C, D, E, and zinc. Metabolism in the pink.
Love muffin. Darling. I just thought maybe we'd have a little excitement for once.
Excitement?
Mm-hmm.
You want?
Yeah.
Excitement, you got it.
Yeah?
I just discovered the most amazing statistic in the actuary tables. Let me tell you about it. At the beginning of each demographic cycle, the analysis that comes through the numbers is unbelievable.
No! No predictability. No, thank you. Not in this lifetime. Now maybe it's because I can't have him. Or maybe it's the dangerous part of him that attracts me the most. It's not the pale moon that excites me. The thrills and delights me. Oh, no. It's just the
the bad boy of Bensonhurst?
Sounds like a Cirillo bread to me. What's up, Lois?
Well, I just happened to be in town, and I'm about to meet a friend of mine at the Outback, and I thought to myself, self, I think Sonny would love to join us.
You're meeting a friend?
Uh-huh. Very cute. Uh-huh. Total finery.
Oh, and this friend, does she approve of my joining you?
Actually, I haven't told her.
You see, she sort of had a falling out with this guy that I think she's really nuts about.
Uh-huh.
And I figured this would be the perfect way to help her, you know, get over it.
You're a regular Cupid.
Yeah, well, it'd be nice if somebody got lucky in love tonight. And it doesn't look like it's going to be me.
You're the best. I owe you one.
See you in a few.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
What is it going to be? Table for two?
Yeah, come on. Three. I invited Sonny. What? Brent, hear me out, okay? How could you invite him here after what he did to me? What is the matter with you? Oh, well,
I'm gonna...
No, you won't. No, you won't. A little male...